Hello everybody, and a very warm welcome to LMT YouTube channel.
Prince Harry and Prince William today set aside their own differences to unveil a statue as a permanent memorial to their beloved mother on what would have been her 60th birthday. Harry and William said they wished their mother was still alive as they stood side by side during an emotional reunion at Kensington Palace today. The brothers were pictured standing shoulder to shoulder before revealing a statue created in Princess Diana's honor by Ian Rank Broadley and placed in the remodeled sunken garden, a place of solace and safety for her before she died in 1997. Unveiling a statue to Princess Diana, the brothers poignantly said, "Every day we wish she were still with us, and our hope is that this statue will be seen forever as a symbol of her life and her legacy." The pair laughed and joked together as they came face to face for the first time since Prince Philip's funeral in April. They didn't give a speech at the service, but instead released a statement to the world's media. "Today, on what would have been our mother's 60th birthday, we remember her love, strength and character, qualities that made her a force for good around the world, change in countless lives for the better. The eyes of the world may have been on the men today, but they appeared closer than ever." As they entered the sunken garden, William and Harry mirrored each other, walking with their left hands touching their stomachs. Both clutched at the green curtain covering the statue, and William asked, "Ready?" before they pulled it off in sync to reveal the touching artwork. A round of applause echoed around the garden, a favorite place of Princess Diana's, as the statue was shown for the first time. Harry joked with his mother's siblings at the event, kissing his aunt Lady Sarah McCorquodale on both cheeks before proceeding to give two more mock pecks as she wagged her finger at him. He also laughed as he saw his aunt Lady Jane Fellows and Uncle Earl Spencer, and the brothers later shared jokes with their guests. "Today's event is small, with just a handful of guests invited, not including the Queen, who is on official duties in Scotland, or Prince Charles. Prince William and Prince Harry wanted the statue to recognize her positive impact in the UK and around the world, and help future generations understand the significance of her place in history. The statue aims to reflect the warmth, elegance, and energy of Diana, Princess of Wales, in addition to her work and the impact she had on so many people. The figure of Diana, Princess of Wales, is surrounded by three children who represented universality and generational impact of the princess' work. The portrait and style of dress featured was based on the final period of her life as she gained confidence in her role as an ambassador for humanitarian causes. The statue aims to convey her character and compassion. Beneath the statue is a plinth engraved with the princess' name and the date of the unveiling. The brothers, who have been split by Harry's decision to leave the UK, were seen chatting in the grounds of Kensington Palace moments before the grand unveiling. Before the event, William appeared to be talking earnestly to his brother, who looked serious as they walked towards the ceremony in an area packed with 4,000 of Diana's most loved flowers and plants surrounding a rectangular pool of water.
Another analysis.
Is this how Princess Diana would have felt about Meghan Markle? It's been a few months since Prince Harry and Meghan Markle broke the internet by opening up to Oprah Winfrey about their difficulties as working members of the royal family, which included accusations of racism and intense bullying. In the months since, it seems as though almost everyone has offered their two cents about what various members of the royal family really think about the ongoing controversy. And in the case of Harry's late mother, Princess Diana, who is sadly no longer with us, royal watchers have continued to speculate about what her reaction would have been to the drama. In April 2021, Us Weekly reported that, according to royal expert Andrew Morton, Diana would not have approved of the infamous interview Harry and Meghan gave to Oprah. Morton, who consulted on Netflix's mega hit The Crown, said, "She would have felt that Harry and Meghan probably went nuclear way too soon." However, given Diana's well-documented issues with privacy and press intrusion, it seems more likely that she would have bonded with Meghan over the paparazzi and the royal family. Strong personalities on both sides could have led to clashes. Meanwhile, royal biographer Katie Nichol told The Sun's Fabulous magazine that Princess Diana would have been delighted to see Prince William settle down with wife and so-called perfect match Kate Middleton, but the People's Princess might have had more trouble accepting Prince Harry's wife, Meghan. According to Nichol, the beloved royal would likely have had mixed feelings about her two daughters-in-law. Acknowledging, "It's tough to guess how Diana would really feel about Meghan," the author surmised. She would have loved the fact that Harry married a biracial, divorced Hollywood actress. This was Harry shaking things up, whether that was or wasn't what he set out to do. However, the Sussexes' decisions to leave the royal family and open up so frankly about their many issues with the firm might have given Diana pause. Although the late royal felt comfortable criticizing Prince Charles, Nichol stated, Diana dropped a royal bomb on Charles by suggesting he wouldn't have been a suitable king, but she would never have dared to criticize the queen. Harry and Meghan haven't been as clever as she was. Furthermore, Ingrid Seward, who edits Majesty magazine, suggested that the two women would have clashed due to their strong personalities. Seward speculated Meghan also would not have felt comfortable taking Diana's advice, which could have caused conflict between them.
First of all, you don't know me. Second of all, you don't know me.
Princess Diana may have been intimidated by Meghan Markle. Princess Diana's biographer, Andrew Morton, shot back at claims she wouldn't have gotten along with Meghan. As the Mirror notes, Morton, who memorably penned Diana, her true story, in her own words, which was released in 1992, explained, she would have been taken aback on first meeting Meghan, a force of nature able to speak with passion and precision, and all without notes. In particular, Diana's biographer thinks the late princess would have been impressed by Meghan's public speaking abilities, which is something she worked to get better at for most of her life. Morton echoed what other royal experts have already argued about Diana's impression of Kate Middleton, while also suggesting, as for Meghan, she would find the energetic American an intimidating. However, Morton thinks that Diana's impression of Meghan would change over time, and that they'd quickly find common ground. But as she got to know her and see the vulnerable side of a woman who suffered mental trauma during her first pregnancy, as did Diana, they would have bonded. The Oving mother would be happy for Prince Harry regardless. According to those who were close to the late Princess Diana, she most likely would have just wanted her sons to be happy. The Mirror quotes Diana's former friend, the Duchess of York, Sarah Ferguson, as saying, she'd really just be so proud. During an appearance on Good Morning Britain, Fergie noted, even before they got married, Diana would have been just literally going, I can't believe these boys have done so well. According to Ferguson, the people's princess would have embraced her son's wives too, because both women are doing equally well in life. Diana's former butler, Paul Burrell, went even further, telling Closer magazine, Harry went for and married Meghan, because she's like Diana.
She chooses me and I choose her.
Although the two women might have clashed occasionally, because they're both known as strong-willed and intent on standing up for what they believe in, there's no denying the similarities between the two of them. This, coupled with Diana's motherly love toward Prince Harry, would likely have guaranteed a sweet relationship between the most important women in his life.
Check out one of our newest videos right here, plus even more LMT videos about your favorite stuff. For coming soon, subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one. Stop.